Hello, everyone. My name is Sam. I directed this here play. Thank you all for coming to the Green Room's production of Dropping Red Pencil, The Lord of the Rings. A lovely, fun parody that we've spent the entirety of the semester so far working very hard on. And again, just thank you all for coming. I just heard the speech. Exits. This usual exit is blocked by these bleachers being out. There's an exit here, which is probably what you will want to use in case of emergency or just if you need it. There's also an exit backstage, but I would probably refrain from using that because it is blocked and the actors need it. There's a walkway here. The line that I have instructed the actors to not cross is between the middle of these doors and the middle of those doors. So please also do not cross that. If you need to exit for any reason, use that right door. And also do be careful on the bleachers. The steps are quite steep. There's nothing we can do about that. And if you are sitting on the edge, be mind that there is a gap there. If your chair scoots, try not to scoot your chair over because a leg might fall into that gap. And that would, I have no idea what would happen. It seems like not a good idea. Yes, and all of you, please remember to wear a mask during the show. If you have a paper, like this, one of these, the Pilton mask on them, please also use that. It's fine if you do not have one. Silence all cell phones. This is a theater. We're doing theater stuff. Actors will be masked off stage, but will be taking their masks off when coming on stage, as is the seeming standard for performances at this college, whether they be music or theatrical. That seems to be the theme that we have fit. And just thank you all for coming and for going Grammy Award-winning artist comment. Much greater performance. And I hope you all enjoy.
It all began with the forging of the great rings. Three were given to the elves. Seven to the dwarves. Nine rings were gifted to the race of men. But they were all of them deceived. From the land of Mordor, the Dark Lord Sauron forged in secret a master ring to control all others. One ring to rule them all. But at last, the loyalist of men and elves defeated the Dark Lord and his ring passed out of all knowledge for 3,000 years. Until, by chance, it passed into the possession of a hobbit. One Frodo Baggins.
And that, Frodo, is why you must leave the Shire and head to Rivendell immediately. The forces of Mordor will step at nothing to get that ring from you. You aren't safe here.
I have heard tales. Tales of dark creatures creeping towards the Shire, stirring in the east,
and barking. Hold on a moment. This isn't what I had in mind when I said I wanted to go on an adventure with you. I mean, Uncle Bilbo's old stories never mentioned the forces of Mordor chasing me.
This isn't some fun vacation with your Uncle Bilbo, Frodo. You must go quickly. Avoid the lunch having passed so
That's not gonna work for me. You see, when I inherited this ring, I also inherited this here property. At one, Bagshot Row, Hobbiton, the Shire.
I don't see the property.
And I can't give that up to go on some daring adventure.
Frodo, my dear boy, you must. The ring, it's...
Look, I'm flattered that you want my help, but I'm just not that kind of hobbit anymore. Here, Gandalf, you take the ring.
No. No, my dear boy.
Why not? You're strong. You're powerful. You can protect it. You've probably been to Rivendell hundreds of times. You could get the ring there much faster than I could.
It's too...
Don't even offer it to me, Frodo.
There's no telling what I'd do if...
Okay! No need to be weird about it. I'll go to Rivendell. Sam! Great timing! Would you mind watching my house for me while I'm gone?
Gone? Where are you going?
Don't play the fool, Samwise Gamgee.
Please don't hurt me.
I know you've been eavesdropping.
I haven't been dropping no news, ma'am. Honest. But if you're going on an adventure, Mr. Frodo, I want to come with you.
But I need someone to look after my house for me. We're in a bull market on housing. Its value is due to go up.
No, Frodo. I think joining you is the perfect punishment for young Samwise here. The journey will be dark and dangerous. You will be pursued by servants of the Dark Lord every step. Does that mean we could go too?
Yeah, I run a small travel blog in the Shire and I'd love to get some locations beyond.
Confound it all, you insufferable hobbits. Fine. You can all go to Rivendell. I have business to attend to elsewhere. I will catch up with you later.
Well, that...
That made no sense at all.
Why do we trust this wizard anyway?
She has a big stick, Mary. Do you have a big stick?
No, Pippin, I don't.
Precisely. And now I believe Mary and I have some wares to acquire before we begin our journey. Go on ahead, we'll meet you on the road.
Well, come on, Mr. Frodo, let's get going. Come on.
I think I might have left my curling iron on, Sam, back at my house. We should go back.
Mr. Frodo, you did not leave your curling iron on. We have to go now.
But if my house burns down, the property value will plummet, and my insurance premiums will skyrocket.
Your house is a hole in a hillside. I don't really see how it could burn down.
Is it Sam? You think we should go back and check on my curling iron? I think we should go back and check on my curling iron.
No, it's just... This is it.
This is what, Sam?
If I take one more step, it'll be the farthest from home I've ever been.
Come on, Sam. What is it now, Sam?
This is it.
This is what, Sam?
If I take one more step, it'll be the farthest from home I've ever been.
Come on, Sam. What, Sam?
If I take one more step, it'll be the farthest.
For the love of Gandalf, Sam, get on with it! What, Sam?
Say where she was meeting us.
No, she just said she had business elsewhere and would catch up.
Just like a wizard. She gives us all sorts of dire instructions and then doesn't even stick around to see him through. No, look at this.
There, Sam. I'm sure she had her reasons.
Not reasons enough, if you ask me, Mr. Frodo. According to her, it is vital that we get that ring to Rivendell and... We don't even know the way.
I know parts of the way from Bilbo's old stories, and besides,
we get lost, we'll have Merry and Pippin there with us, so at least we won't be lonely.
That's not exactly comforting.
All right, our journey under the Rivendell begins. We're taking the back road.
No, it's not the way.
We're gonna get lost as hell.
I think the entertainment's good. Gotta save your battery.
Why?
Because there are no outlets in Middle Earth.
Right. Hey guys.
What took you guys so long?
Oh, we stopped to get some mushrooms on the way.
Oh great, I can fry them up for dinner.
Oh, you should not expose these to heat.
Hurts their potency.
Guys. Seriously, you didn't get any edible ones?
Oh, they're edible.
But not for a meal.
Speak for yourself.
All right. Merry, Pippin, you are respectable, gentle hobbits from important political families. You are not to ingest those mushrooms in any way, shape, or form.
Not even in tea?
No. As soon as we get to Rivendell, we are selling them to the richest elves we can find.
That's a good idea.
We should go. And that is why land ownership is the best form of investment.
That's great, Frodo.
So it doesn't lose its value?
Well, if you collude with other landowners, which isn't hard because they're all our cousins, it could potentially cause a housing shortage to artificially inflate.
Okay, what was that?
I think we might be...
What is that?
It looks like a dementor!
What's a dementor?
Never mind, is anyone feeling depressed?
I'm always depressed.
Shut up, Frodo!
Oh my god, we're all going to die!
Yeah! Oh. Gone for long.
Who are you?
The folks around these parts call me Strider. Those things were once kings, but they've been corrupted, twisted servants of Mordor.
Did that mean anything to anyone?
No.
I am Aragorn, son of Arathorn. I am a ranger of the north. It doesn't matter, we should get moving.
Now, hold up. Nobody said you could come with us. It's great that you saved us and all, but how do we know we can trust you? You don't even know where we're going.
Gandalf sent me to escort four hobbits to Rivendell. I assume that's you.
And why didn't she come herself?
I don't know. She said she had business elsewhere that she might get held up.
All right, that sounds like Gandalf. I believe you.
All right, well, we best get moving. What are you doing?
Well, excuse me. All this excitement has gotten me rather peckish, and it's high time for second breakfast.
I don't think humans have second breakfast, Pip.
What? No second breakfast? What about elevenses?
No.
What do you eat? Lunch?
Look, all right, let's get moving. Okay, Rivendell is still many days' walk from here, and we must be there in time for the council!
Late night vow? Surely you have late night vow.
Orc minions, reveal to me the mirror of Saruman. The hour is upon us.
You got a date or something, Gav?
With Gandalf? Pardon you, oaf. One must always be in peak presentation when attempting to persuade.
Well, are you sure this ain't got nothing to do with your personal history?
She's not. The personal lives of the Maiar are too complex for the mind of an orc. Simply conceive of this as a sale or a candidate interview.
Right.
Gav, I've got a question.
If you must.
This Sauron guy, gonna raise my taxes?
As in the Dark Lord of Mordor, Sauron. The all-seeing, flaming eye in sky. The Lord of the Rings himself?
Yeah, that dude.
Do you think he bothers with tax policy?
Well, any decent overlord's gotta have a tax plan or two. I mean, how else does Mordor afford all this crazy shit?
Well, surely at least Noah stands on workplace discrimination. Saruman of many colors.
Oh, you two be quiet!
Saruman!
Conceal yourselves! Gandalf, my old friend! You have come to seek my counsel!
What the hell are you doing?
It's a handshake. New greeting. Popular in merchant circles. I'm a modern woman, prepared for a new age.
Merchant circles. Right.
What was it that you wanted to tell Saruman the Wise?
Rings back.
What?
Rings back.
Like the ring?
Yeah, that one.
Where is it?
You're never gonna forgive me for this.
Oh, speak the truth, Gandalf. You can trust me.
Why did you just...
Oh, never mind. Just speak your knowledge.
It was in the Shire.
Bilbo had it.
The Shire you keep loitering around? The Bilbo you are friends with? You never noticed that he had the ring?
How much weed have you been smoking?
Not nearly enough.
It's just as well. You'll need a clear head now that Sauron's back.
What?
Sauron's back.
Like the Sauron, the fiery eye?
Yeah, that one.
How do you know that?
I've seen it.
What?
A seeing stone? Saruman, be careful, those are dangerous. They are not all accounted for. I have a wonderful accountant. Oh, I see what you mean. Don't worry about it, we mass produce these things now. Even some of the hobbits have them.
Right, Pippin has...
Wait, you what? You can't mass produce magic that powerful? The only true magical force in this universe, Gandalf, is the invisible hand of the market. I told you, I'm a modern woman, a captain of industry. Orcs, disrobe me.
Out of all the times I've seen you disrobe, this somehow manages to be the most disgusting of it all. Where did you get the money for any of this? Where did you get orcs?
Sauron is preparing an invasion of Middle-earth. Isengard Industries is my labor of love. It cannot compete with the power of Mordor. Him the eye cloaked in flames sees all. He knows all of the demands and whims of the market. So, if the fiery eye offers my humble company an investment, why not join him?
And I suppose he physically threatened you, like this is a life or death kind of analysis for you?
Oh, certainly. I totally accepted his investment offer under duress. He said, build me an army, or I'll use it to kill you.
Sell out?
I'm advancing my career, claiming a place at the table. The big boys of business need me, and they need you. Join me. Gandalf, I need an executive vice president for Isengard Industries. It's too late to change the fate of Middle-earth. I mean, the Nazgul already scoured the Shire. Frodo! Oh. Listen to me, Gandalf. Do you know how many female CEOs there are in Middle-earth? I am changing this world.
Oh, you are subservient to the physical manifestation of evil. Gaslighting me.
What in Illuminator's name is the CEO?
Well, here in the business world, we like to have
Seitz! I don't care! Tell me, when did Saruman the Wise abandon reason for madness?
I have not! I am a rational, profit-maximizing agent!
You know, this might just be good for us. If Gandalf won't join the biz, we might just get her job ourselves.
A promotion? Yeah, I can see myself climbing that corporate ladder.
Yeah, but do you think that'd change us?
Absolute power does corrupt absolutely.
You have a point, but isn't corruption sort of inherent to an orc's nature?
Perhaps it is. And I guess absolute power is what reigns in that very corruption. Who knows what would happen without our boss Saruman and Sovereign Sorrow?
Yeah, the old orc state of nature is awfully nasty and rooted.
Just like corporate.
Hey! Stop that! You declined a lucrative
stupid job offer, Gandalf! You should have seen that salary! But instead, you lost your chance to help close the wage gap! You have elected the way of pain!
Boss.
Strangers from distant lands, friends of old. You have been summoned here to answer to the threat of Mordor. Middle-earth stands upon the brink of destruction. None shall escape it. You will unite, or you will fall. Each race is bound to this one fate, this one ring, Frodo. Very well, then. I am Elrond Half-Elven, Lord of Rivendell. And let's get ready to council! She's been named Olorin, Mithrandir, and Stormcrow, but I get to call her my old friend. She's one of the five Ishtar, in order of the Maiar, sent by the Valar to combat Sauron. Okay, not even I know what that means. But anyway, you know her, you love her, she's gray, she's gay, and she'll get in your way. It's Gandalf! Next on the docket, the heir to Isildur and the true king of Gondor. This royal ranger isn't afraid to do what needs to be done. I raised him like a son when his father was slaughtered by orcs. Ouchie. He's a lean, mean fighting machine and cute to boot. It's Aragorn!
I'm not like other kings. I like dirt.
Next up, the son of the Steward of Gondor. His daddy's in charge because Aragorn's been playing hide and seek in the woods instead of claiming his birthright. So basically, this next individual is the son of a substitute teacher, and all the power's gone to his head real fast. He's not trustworthy and plot and betrayal. But gosh darn it, we just can't stay mad at that face. It's Boromir!
That ring looks tasty.
Be wary, friends, for I'm impervious to harm. I cannot be killed unless three arrows strike me in succession. First one in the heart, and then two in the abdomen. And what are the odds that'll happen, right?
Guys, good luck with that guy.
This seems nice.
Here we go. The one you've all been waiting for. The Elven Prince of Mirkwood. Which is cool, I guess, but it's no Rivendell. What to know about this guy? He does all his own stunts and pretty much never misses. But if there's one thing to know, and one thing only, it's that he's hot, okay? Like, really, really hot. Like, insanely hot. I can't stress this enough. This dude popped put Mount Doom to shame, you dig? Orlando blew me away. And he'll do the same to you. It's Legolas!
You're welcome.
And we can't forget his unlikely partner, the dwarf with the beard that hipsters would kill for. He's overtly racist to elves throughout the entire trilogy, and yet no one bats an eye. Standing at 4'6", with
you?
That will never change.
You got that right.
What a kooky bunch.
You can say that again. Now that the introductions are over, let the Council of Elrond commence!
So, that's the one ring, huh? Right. Could I have it?
No.
Okay, could I have it, please?
No. Sorry.
What? Pretty please? I'd use it to fight Sauron. Fighting fire with fire always works.
It's a hard no, Boromir. Move on.
Excuse me? You can't talk to me that way. Do you know who my father is? He's the freaking steward of Gondor, okay? Good luck when he hears about this.
I hate to break it to you, buddy, but Aragorn is the king of Gondor.
This is the heir to Isildur, but he's all dirty.
Wait, and were you listening? Okay, I like dirt.
It makes me more manly. You wouldn't understand. Boromir, son of Dinathor, Aragorn, son of Aragorn, quit your squabbling. The doom of Middle-earth is at hand.
Aragorn is right. We cannot use it.
You are correct, Legolas, son of Thranduil. We have but one option. The ring must be destroyed.
Sweet.
The ring cannot be destroyed by any craft that we here possess, Gimli, son of Gloin.
Get it, Elrond. You're immortal, you knew all of our dads.
Wait. Gimli, your dad's name is
Gloin. What of it? What was his dad's name?
Groin.
No, seriously, what was his name?
Groin.
You're kidding!
I'm serious. My grandpa's name was Groin. It's in the books. Google it during intermission or something.
I'll never understand dwarves.
Hey, while we're on the topic of parentage, do you know that my dad is a steward of God?
Yes! Like I was saying, we cannot destroy it here. The ring was made in the fires of Mount Doom. Only there can it be unmade. It must be taken deep into Mordor and cast back into the fiery chasm from whence it came. One of you must do this.
Nose goes.
Damn it! But I don't even know the way there.
Well, it's about 1,800 miles vaguely southeast of here, if that helps.
That's about the distance it would take to get from Kansas to Florida.
Kansas? Florida?
Don't worry about it. It's for the audience.
Okay, fine. 1,800 miles. But how will I get there? Horseback? Ooh, Elrond, do you have a carriage? I can pay. I own property.
No, nothing like that. But you can use those big old hairy hobbit feet of yours.
I have to walk?
Hiya, folks, it's me again, the Giant Eagle from the last scene. I was just a passenger in the neighborhood. You know, I was actually on my way to Mordor anyway. We eagles fly south for the winter, you know migration? So, if you wanted a lift, I could take you all the way there on my back. Really, no trouble at all. Check me out, I'm an eagle.
Actually, that would be really
nice. We don't want your hand out! Get out of here, girl! I'll eat you!
What an asshole!
Like, read the room.
So that's it then? I'm going all on my lonesome?
One does not simply walk into Mordor. Two on the other hand, that should work. I'll come with. My daddy would want me to tag along anyway.
I too shall accompany you, and I'll perform some of my neato magic tricks. You should see my smoke rings.
If by my life or death I can defend you, I will. You have my sword.
And you have my ox.
And my cloth.
Jesus Christ!
Three guns. Three.
Mr. Frodo's not going anywhere without me.
Samwise Gamgee. This was a secret council meeting.
You never know. You might need a gardener on this quest.
Did someone say a road trip?
Look at the content.
You can use some mukbangs on the way.
Okay, fine. You guys can come too.
Nine companions. Sure, why not? You shall be the Fellowship of the Ring!
He said it! He said the thing!
Mordor or bust!
Dark, twisted beasts will tear you limb from limb without a sound. These are the mines of Moria.
Surely the great and powerful dwarves aren't scared of a few mines.
I'd like to see you take one, pretty boy. Lucky for you, my cousin Bellin's been holding them up for as long as I can remember. I can't imagine anything bad possibly happening to him.
I hate to break up the chit-chat, but it appears that this door is blocked by some kind of password. Gimli, I trust you know it.
I do.
Are you gonna type it in?
No.
Are you gonna be a big baby about it?
My honor, there's a dwarf for a bit, my typing.
We don't have time for this! Okay, look. It says there's a stupid riddle on this stupid door. You need a stupid password. It says, if you wish to gain entry, you must simply think, what is the kind of cousin Gimli's stink?
So we just have to say what Gimli smells like.
Eagle droppings? Wet Nazgul.
I promise you, we dwarfs through hands much better than we smell.
No, it has to be Ent pubes.
It says here it must contain both dwarvish runes and numbers.
Numbers? Then the password could be anything. How are we possibly going to...
Ent pubes, 69.
Nice.
You're a genius, Mr. Frodo! An absolute genius!
Welcome to the Mimes of Moria. Always remember, do not feed the mimes, no matter how much they hunger you for flesh. Enjoy your stay.
That's inviting.
There are a lot of dead bodies for a prosperous city.
These must be all the mimes we can flee.
These are awfully short for mimes.
They've had their legs cut off.
Strangely dwarf-shaped skulls.
You seem awfully familiar with dwarf skulls, elf.
What was that? That's Gollum. The wicked creature's been tracking us for the past 3 days, but thankfully he doesn't show up in the first movie. He's upstairs doing homework for now.
Hi. I remember my Uncle Bilbo telling me stories about him.
I used to think he was so funny. But now that he's following us, it's actually really gross. I hate being followed by creepy monsters. I wish I had never gotten this awful ring. I wish none of this had ever happened.
Frodo, you must hold strong. Only you can complete this quest. You lost a game of nose goes, and nose goes never lies. Nose goes always knows who goes, and your nose now goes just like Bilbo's. Right.
You think he bought that?
I don't know. I was just peeking out of my ass.
That it is. Me cousin Bellin's old bedroom.
Let me have a lick of that anxiety while he's there.
Oh no!
The mimes must have gotten the poor fellow.
I think we should really admit the mimes got everybody.
There, little buddy. Let it all out.
Oh, tell me why! Why did you have to go so soon? I still remember the golden days of our youth, frolicking through the mines, shouting frog soup, stroking each other's bears. I'll never forget the time we spent together. Hey! Nobody lovingly embraces a dwarf.
My mistake. I simply mistook you for a large malformed baby.
Skip it out!
Cry baby dwarf.
Hey Mary, are you thinking what I'm thinking?
That Gimli would be much happier if he cared less about maintaining his toxic masculine image.
But no! Mary, can't you see? This is prime content! Tragic tales, ancient caverns, this is exactly the kind of stuff our subscribers want.
You cannot be more right, Pippin. Matter of fact, we should go live right now. Considering we're underground, we have surprisingly good internet connection.
Yo, what is up, Hobheads? It's your boy, Big Pip, coming at you live from the mines of Moria. Check this place out!
Fill up a talk! You've given away our location to the entire internet! Don't you know that Saruman is extremely online? Be on your guards! This is no ordinary mind, this is a Balrog, the most twisted and French of all! Fly, you fools! I'll hold it back.
Don't worry, I've got this. If you can't do the mime, don't do the crime.
Can't you see the fiend is wearing an invisible bulletproof vest?
Look out!
Go! Oh, thank goodness it's a terrible shot and he missed! Oh,
I'm so glad no one got hurt. It would have sucked if that happened.
Go!
Thanks for taking one for the team, Boromir. We can always count on you.
I can barely feel it.
That's our Boromir.
Everybody wait! My shoelace is coming undone. I need to retie it.
Oh, don't be stupid. We have to keep going.
Do you want me to trip and fall? Didn't your mother ever teach you? Very rude. He wants those kind of shoes.
Shame on you, Pippin. Shame on you.
What are you, idiot? We're hobbits. We don't wear shoes.
Right. Can you just go already? Get off. Oh, please. You may have the upper hand, but our quest does not end here. Frodo shall destroy the ring. Peace shall be restored, and you shall not. Yes, my boy, we did.
There's nothing.
Get off, no!
There's nothing we can do. Let's go.
Sometimes people leave us before their time. They come into your life, and they change your entire worldview. You go to every one of their concerts. You buy all their merch at Hot Topic. You memorize every one of their songs. And then one day, they just disappear, leaving you with nothing but memories and four studio albums.
I can't believe you're comparing my Chemical Romance breaking up to the death of Frodo's mother figure.
You wouldn't understand.
She was always more of a kooky gay why not, really.
Losing a kooky gay why not isn't any easier.
I know, Pip. I know. I'm gonna miss stealing her fireworks from you.
At least we can dedicate the next vlog to her.
Yeah, she'd like that. She really would.
Yeah, she would. Yeah, she would. It's gonna be okay, buddy.
All right, enough of this nonsense. We must make the for Gondor. Daddy doesn't like to be kept waiting.
Come, we must travel through the woods of Finkle Dink or whatever.
Can't we just take a second to...
Right, everyone. Three, one.
Fellowship out!
approaching the woods of Lothlorien. These are my father's kin. Impossibly beautiful. Much better looking than the likes of you.
Yeah? Lie on a bear! You're a bear, baby face!
Look, one does not simply walk into Lothlorien.
Corcoran!
Is that any way to talk to your future grandmother-in-law, son of Lothlorien? I thought you had more manners than that. Where's Gandalf?
No, you see.
She died.
She did. We lost her. The mind of Moria. She saved us all.
Gandalf was a true friend to the peoples of Middle-earth. But I forget myself. My name is Kate Blanchett, Lady of Lothlorien, and I would offer you hospitality if you wish.
What did you say your name was?
Kate Blanchett. Look at my beautiful hair.
But I, you...
Slave! Ah, you must be the ring bearer. I see you have the power to resist my command.
Look, I don't know what you
do
want,
do you want
lady.
To see your future?
Sure. Why not?
My mirror shows many things. Things that are, things that were, and things that may yet come to pass. Look into the mirror, Frodo. What do you see?
I see fire. Everything's on fire. And there are these strange carts with no horses, and one of them is painted red and has eyes and... Ka-chow. I think I left my curling iron on. Do you know how often curling irons start fires more than you think? Here, you take the ring. You can take it to Mordor, can't you? With your power? Oh, please, Kate Blanchett.
I would gladly take the ring. And in place of a dark lord, you would have a queen! Beautiful and powerful as the dawn! All shall love me in despair!
Fuck off! Fine!
Finish my quest.
Cool. Oh, and before you go, I have a gift for you, ring bearer.
What kind of gift?
A very special gift from my people. The light of Arendelle.
A flashlight. My property could be burning down. Gandalf is dead, and you give me a flashlight?
Remember this, Frodo. Use the light of Arendelle for a very specific purpose that you'll find out later.
Everyone wants the ring so badly. I can't even trust allies anymore. Can I even trust my friends?
Shh! Trying to sleep.
Okay.
Smell anything.
Me neither.
Why does it take this party so long to walk anywhere?
Half of them have little legs.
Well, I'm sick and tired of waiting. I've got a thought.
What a novelty.
How come Saruman ain't here?
She's the boss.
She's a wizard. Not even Gandalf could stand up to her. She'd wipe the floor with these bozos.
Yeah! You're right. What the hell is Saruman doing?
Collecting a fat stack of Sauron books, that's what. Sending us orcs to die? She thinks we're expendable!
Yeah, Saruman and Sauron want the kid with the ring so bad, they can do it themselves! We didn't sign up for danger like this!
Yeah, and it's not like the factories in Isengard are much safer. I mean, this week alone, we lost three arms, a foot, an eye, a horn and a half, 17 teeth, 11 of which were fangs, a pet bird, a septum, and my fucking toe!
Well, at least out here we get man flesh as compensation.
That's not a fair compensation plan. That's treating us like literal monsters. We should lobby for workplace safety protection.
OSHA?
Orca.
Lamau.
Wait, do you smell that?
The devil's weed.
And end pews.
They're here.
I still think our next move should be to Gondor. We'll be absolutely safe in Nis Tirith, and no one will try to take the ring there.
Why do you have to say it like that? Now we definitely can't go to Gondor.
What are you talking about? Look, I swear on my life that nobody's gonna try to take the ring from Frodo. No matter how tempting it is.
All in favor of not going to Minas Tirith?
Come on, you guys! You were willing to trust the elves, even Academy Award-winning actress Kate Blanchett. Why not place your trust in the men of Gondor, huh?
He's gonna tell them.
Certainly not I.
You know what? This is man-phobic.
What?
Prejudice against the race of men.
Okay, like, men-men or humans? And does this apply to women as well? I've heard you humans can get weird about women sometimes.
The second one. And yes,
that's ridiculous. Aragorn's a man. We trust him.
Yeah, he was a man raised by elves, okay? He's a self-hating man.
Boromir, don't be an idiot, okay? We've all seen you staring at the ring. And besides, you're gonna fight for men's rights and for all men. Being raised by elves doesn't make me less of a man.
And yet your internalized man phobia reveals itself. You believe all men are inherently untrustworthy.
Okay, why are humans untrustworthy? I'm a little lost here.
We elves don't think humans are untrustworthy, rather a bit fragile.
Legolas has a point.
Well, isn't it convenient that Aragorn is part elf then?
Boromir, don't be ridiculous!
Look, the fact of the matter is, you don't like me, because I'm a dude. All right, I'm a nice guy. There's no other possible reason.
Except for the fact that you regularly stare at the ring whilst licking your lips.
And you bring up the ring in every conversation, even when it has nothing to do with what we're talking about.
And you keep mentioning how powerful it is and how useful it could be.
And you've been stealing my phone to watch first-person shooter games on YouTube.
Yes? Since when?
Yeah, I caught him out the other night. Plus, my search history was all weird. I don't watch Call of Duty playthroughs.
Oh!
Wait, I'm confused. What on earth does that have to do with anything?
A privileged upbringing from a wealthy family with an overbearing father coupled with a weird military fixation? Yeah, it's just not a good vibe.
I bet he's on Reddit, too.
I am, actually, but that's not—
Where's Mr. Frodo?
Great, now we've lost the ring. I mean, we've lost Frodo. Great work, guys.
What are you talking about? This is your—
Quit arguing! We have to split up and look for him!
Frodo!
Mr. Frodo!
Frodo! Amigo!
Who knew? Boromir is actually a men's rights activist.
So much power in such a small piece of candy.
Boromir?
The others think men can't be trusted with the ring, that we're weak and will fall prey to its wiles.
Step away from me, Boromir.
But not all men are weak, Frodo. Not all men. We're not animals. We can control ourselves.
You know, I really try to stay out of politics.
Give me the ring. Let me prove it.
No.
Give me the ring, Frodo.
No.
Frodo. Frodo. I'm sorry. I don't know what came over me. Come back. We can talk about this. The rest of the fellowship might hate my political views, but that doesn't mean we can't be friends, right?
You're completely missing the point, Boromir! I don't care about your politics. Can't you see? The ring has ensnared you!
No, it hasn't!
Yes, it has! Everyone in the Fellowship can see it but yourself!
And how do the others know they're not ensnared, huh?
The ring will take them all in the end. You're right about that. Which is why I'm leaving.
What?
Hobbits are vulnerable, you know, Boromir. I've come to realize that during our journey. We're half your size and have no magical abilities. If Aragorn or Legolas or even Gimli tried to take the ring from me, I would be overpowered. No. If the ring is to be destroyed, I must do it alone. Good day, sir.
Wait! Oh!
Frodo.
Frodo! Frodo! Frodo!
Boromir, have you found Frodo?
He's gone.
What?
I said he's... books. You two should run. Find Aragorn and the others. I'll hold them off for as long as I can.
But
Frodo was right. I've had my head up my ass this entire quest. Do you know, upon reflecting for about 5 seconds, I think I might have some serious daddy issues. But I recognize the problem, and therefore, I'm cured. Now go! I shall protect you!
His victim complex turned into a savior complex rather quickly.
I think maybe those two aren't so different.
All right, bitches. Looks like you're coming with the orcs.
Wait!
Hey!
No!
Next try.
Yes!
Oh, shit! No!
Yeah!
Oh, my God, it's over here.
What happened? Remember how I said a while back, I could only be killed if one arrow struck me in the heart and then two more in the belly area?
Ah, so you jinxed it.
Pretty much, yeah, that's what happened.
I only see one arrow.
It appears that weakness applies to bullets as well as arrows, Gimli.
I see.
Wait 1 second. Where are the orcs? We were chasing them and they suddenly disappeared.
Alas, it appears Saruman tasked his orcs with kidnapping the hobbits. They've taken Merry and Pippin. I tried to give chase, but then one of them pulled out a gun and...
It's okay. You did your best.
I'm sorry for being so annoying today.
It's okay. Although you were very annoying today.
Legolas, this is a sensitive moment.
No, Legolas is right. I was really, really annoyed. My passion for men's rights clouded my judgment. I was so preoccupied, I didn't even realize that the ring had claimed me. Now Merry and Pippin have been taken, and I failed them.
It's okay. We will not let your sacrifice be in vain.
Will you hold true to that oath? That I can die in peace.
Yeah! Sorry. One more thing. Frodo decided to leave us and go off on his own.
I tried to take the ring from him, you see, and now he doesn't trust any of us. Also, he kicked me in the balls. Oh!
Thanks for the heads up!
Mr. Frodo!
Sam? What are you doing?
Following you, of course. The others are still pretty worried.
I'm leaving, Sam. For good.
I know. Which is why I'm coming with you.
But you can't, Sam! I would only put you in danger.
I promised Gandalf I would look after you, Mr. Frodo. And, begging your pardon, but I have been in quite a bit of danger already.
Well, that's true, but...
And anyway, you can't cook for shit.
What? What has that got to do with anything?
And you got no sense of direction. Which way is north? Exactly. Plus, you hate bugs.
But...
And sleeping outdoors. And peeing outdoors. You haven't pissed this entire journey.
But that's not the point, Sam. The ring will take you if you come with me.
And I'm saying I don't care. I want to be with you. Where you go, I go, Mr. Frodo. You better get used to it.
Even though I'm a squeamish embarrassment of a traveler, Bilbo would be so disappointed.
I could never be disappointed in you. No matter what. Hey, you can come. Thanks, Mr. Frodo. Well, we best get to stepping then. There's no turning back now. We're too far from home.
Thank you.
end of Act 1, we will...
Mr. Bilbo's old stories were so terribly misleading.
In what way?
Well, the way he told them, they all sounded so exciting. But now I see he must have cut out all the walking bits.
Well, I suppose the walking bits serve no narrative purpose, do they, Sam? You wouldn't want your audience to get bored.
That is true. When we tell our story, I dare say we cut out all the walking bits, too.
I suppose we can. We could probably condense all of the past week's walking into just a few minutes.
We could even cut out this very conversation.
I suppose we can, unless something terribly exciting happens right about now, in which case we might have to include it.
What is that thing?
It's Gollum, the previous ring bearer.
Nasty habits, sister.
If I allow the ring to consume me, I will become a creature like him.
Gross. Let's kill it.
No, please, Gollum knows things. Yes, he does.
Well, we are pretty lost. You're right about my sense of direction, Sam. We've been walking for weeks and made little progress. Do you know the way to Mordor?
Don't trust him, Mr. Frodo. He's clearly being set up to betray us later on.
Oh no, Gollum never betrays the master of Depressions, Mr. Rose. Mr. Rose. Oh, Depressions of soap.
Think of it, Sam. With Gollum to lead us, we can keep the walking bits to a minimum.
All right.
Excellent. Gollum, lead us to Mordor. Hobbitses are awfully gullible.
What did you just say?
Yes, I'm coming along, Hobbitses!
Bushnak over in the engineering department, and he's definitely on our side. Confident he can get his men to join us too. That's a big chunk of the Isengard workers.
I sent a bird to Captain Lug, and Captain Lugduff, and Captain Lugdush, and Captain Bull, and Captain Bogbeg, and Captain Bulldog.
Captain Snagger?
Captain Snagger too.
And?
And I think we have the whole army of Border on our side. Oh, well, except for Bulg. I just killed Bulg though.
Yeah, I won't miss him. That guy was a dick. Shagrat from public relations was also a bit tricky. Let's just say, I publicly relate his face with my axe.
Huh, I kinda like Shagrat.
Well, his job was making you like things.
True, true. And Radbug from Orc Resources.
On board.
Offroad and Logistics, Orcabal the Machinist, Muzgash, Azel, the other Lagduff.
We've got more.
Orc 1, I think we might just pull this up.
Orc 2, I look forward to leading Middle-earth's first workers' union with you.
Excuse me, gentle orc?
How'd you get that out of your mouth, halfling?
Oh, I can do a lot with my mouth.
Those are talking! I mean, as in, that's what you can do with your mouth. You made it weird, and I just wanted to get off that train of thought, so I tried to take the opportunity to roast you. Whatever, I'm just gonna stop talking now.
I can also sing.
Do you have any food?
Gary, what kind of meat is this?
I don't know. Pippin, do not eat that.
Sorry, I'm starving. But, hey, my phone's dead. Don't these guys make phones?
Pippin, stop getting their attention.
I like attention. Hey, you guys got a phone charger?
What percent are you at?
Oh, it's dead.
Okay.
Alright. Occupational hazard insurance. 38-hour work week. One silver piece minimum wage.
Redirecting all the smoke from the workers' faces.
Putting up guardrails in front of the massive pit of death.
These demands are shaping up.
Mary, they have had everything that I've asked for. Are you thinking what I'm thinking?
Pippin, do not under any circumstances ask them.
Hey, you guys got any weed? Come on, Mary, I gotta vlog about this.
Your hands aren't free.
You know, I've been thinking. Wealthies weren't demands, but laws.
What are you suggesting?
Orc 2. Will you perform a coup with me?
Yes, yes, a thousand times yes!
We'll usher in a new era in Middle-earth. We will usher in the dictatorship of the proletariat!
And that's the Vanguard Party!
That according to a guiding Orc-1ism, Orc-2ism ideology.
What kind of Saruman's useless head?
We'll dine on wizard flesh!
I really wish I recorded that.
What just happened?
I don't know. But I feel like we probably shouldn't tell them that we're actually Hobbit royalty.
Agreed. Can you untie my hands with your teeth?
On it.
How did you... Never mind. I'll untie you. We'll make for the forest. We'll hide among the trees. We have to put as much distance between them and us as possible. It's the only way they won't smell that weed.
Mary, do you think I should ask them for a lighter?
Pippin, we both have lighters.
Right, I just assumed I lost mine.
Why did they stop whispering?
They probably thought we were too distracted, which we are. Planning a coup is serious business.
Yeah. I hope they're all right out there.
Are you kidding me? How dare you two interrupt my calm walk through the forest? This is the only time I get to stop thinking about industry, and I'm sure you'll tell me half a dozen new problems to deal with.
We're sorry, boss. We didn't know you was gonna be out here.
I take the same route every time. Forget about it. Where are the hobbits that you meant to have captive?
They,
escaped.
One job. One task. One single measly mission, and you hornheads fuck it up? Demoted. When you get back to Isengard, find the most foul, harrowing line in the factory, and work it. Where did they escape?
40 miles to the northwest. We were ambushed by the King of Gondor himself.
Right. I will dispatch a competent search party. Now, let us address those papers you hold behind your backs.
Damn it.
Didn't you think I wouldn't notice? Hand it to me. Unionizing! You beasts of hell! You mud-dwelling berserkers! You forged in flame freaks! Do you think you have any right to a union in my domain? You two are terminated from this company, effective immediately! Never show your faces in Isengard again, or I will hang that on the factory walls as a reminder! I am putting this union business to rest.
Well, that was disastrous.
We're going ahead with the plan.
We might be shit out of luck if she gets the workers at Isengard a stern talking to.
Well, hopefully something dramatic happens to prevent that.
Some weird forest, and looky what we have here. Quality herbs.
Pippin, that was not the time for you to be yelling at your phone. What if those orcs come back?
Bruh, those orcs were cool. They resupplied us, and they gave me a phone charger. Oh, which reminds me, shout outs to your boys, Orc 1 and Orc 2.
They're out here trying to start a revolution, and I want each and every one of you hopheads to lend them your support.
Pippin! Things out here! Why do you have to go and ask yourself to the whole world in the middle of a strange forest?
Oh, come on, what could possibly be so dangerous?
Chill, it's a tree.
Who goes there?
It's a talking tree. What are the orcs put in this shit?
Shut up!
What are you doing in my swamp? My forest! And what is that? Is that a phone? You brought a phone into Fangorn Forest?
Yo, hopheads, are you seeing this shit? Hey, Mr. Tree Guy, do you want to be featured in my travel vlog?
How dare you propose I engage with the technology that is destroying me and mine? You deserve nothing less than death for defiling Fangorn.
Whoa, okay, Lorax. I didn't know you were such an environmentalist.
I am the environment. I'm an ant.
Nice, us too.
What do you want from us?
I want you to leave, or die, or... Wait, is that purple kush?
Hell yeah, you want some?
Well, I certainly wouldn't mind some. This takes me back to the second day. But only if I can make a statement to your viewers.
Yeah, sure, go ahead. Your boy! Wait, what's your name?
Just go with Treebeard!
Your boy Treebeard is gonna tell us what is up!
Heads of all! I am here to tell you about a vital issue facing all of us today. The excesses and externalities of capitalist imperialism have gone too far! Just 20 leagues to the west, the heartless machines of Isengard Inc. are invading and destroying the last sacred forest of Middle-earth. They are burning it to the ground to make space for industrial production so they can grow their capitalist empire. They are coming for my home. And soon, they will come for yours too. And all that will be left to remember the old free Greenland by will be shitty bags of overprocessed weed.
Wow. Thank you, Treebeard. That was powerful.
Yeah, I'm gonna be honest, I did not get most of that. But I'm pretty sure you said something about destroying a factory, and I am always down for that, even when I'm not high.
Excellent! Comrades to arms!
At least it's a plan of some kind. To arms!
Is old, very old, full of memory and anger.
Was that the night?
Quiet, dwarf! The trees are speaking.
Lower your axe, Gimli.
The elves began it long ago, waking up the trees, teaching them to speak. Axes give them flashbacks.
I don't get it. What would trees have to talk about? Ridiculous. Stones, on the other hand. Ooh, now they would have a story to tell.
What is it, Legolas? What are your elf eyes seeing?
Someone approaches.
Who?
I don't know. Saruman, I think. I don't know. I think my elf eyes might need a new prescription or something.
Saruman, don't let her speak. So cast a spell on us.
You're tracking the footsteps of two young hobbits.
I swear, if a single hair on their heads has been hard.
Tisk, tisk, tisk. They are doing fine, Aragorn. Actually, more than fine. They are, as the kids say, high AFATM Lamau.
Then why should we trust you, Saruman the Deceiver?
That is where you err, Master Elf. I am not Saruman, for I am
an old friend.
Gigos!
But you fell.
I am not yet so old a wizard, Gimli, that when I've fallen, I can't get up. I fought my foe, the Mime of Moria, the accursed Balrog, from the lowest dungeon to the highest peak. Finally, I used his weakness against him, miming a stiff breeze that blew that Peridian parasite off a ledge and smote his ruin upon the mountainside. My power spent, I nearly passed into shadow. But at the last second, I absorbed the mind's power. Watch this. I return to you now at the turn of the tide. I am Gandalf the White.
But we heard Saruman.
Unlike a mime who cannot speak with any voice, I cannot speak with every voice. Allow me to demonstrate.
My name is Saruman. I'm a big, ugly, poopy head. Gandalf is so much smarter and better looking. I worship the ground Gandalf walks on.
Look at me, I'm Frodo. I better not screw up this whole quest.
And now I'm Sam. I like flowers and potatoes and stuff. Yippee!
I'm Boromir. I love my daddy more than anybody in the whole wide world. Everybody thinks I'm so great.
Yeah, actually, about that one. Boromir kind of died.
Oh, shit, really?
Yeah, it was like really sad too. He redeemed himself and everything.
Luvatar, Christ! You can catch me up on the way. We must rendezvous with Myriadoc and Parody.
Steps are taking me any further from home.
Do you think we could stop and get a snack on?
And what would we eat, Sam?
I could really go for some fish and chips.
Where are we going to get fish
Look!
And chips?
Look how smooth your fangs are!
Is that broken?
No, normal kills are sickers. Refined tooths as toasty truths for the habits of.
You're scaring Mr. Frodo! Give me that! I'll make it into a stew.
Stupid hobbit ruins
it! Oh.
Stupid hobbit!
Shut up! You'd love it with some herbs and taters.
What's taters?
Potatoes. Boil them, mash them, stick them in a stew.
Hey guys, I heard you might
You! Stay the hell away from me!
Oh, you must be confusing me for my dead brother, Boromir. Oh! What is that? What is that thing?
Bad man called Smeager thing.
Wait, Boromir died?
Yes. We
We had our differences, but now I'm saddled with the stressful combination of survivor's guilt and being the favorite son by default. It's a whole thing. I'm Faramir, by the way. Captain General Faramir.
Are you gonna try to take the ring too?
Goodness, kid, are you okay? Oh, bless your heart. I'm not gonna try to take the ring from you, honest. A fairy's on a low-carb diet anyway, okay? No sweets for me. But you kids want something to eat? I can get you tea or coffee.
Smeagol already got to Hobbit's food. Stupid, nasty, disgusting man food not needed for Hobbit's and Smeagol.
Huh? Oof. Okay, I'm gonna get you something edible. You're lucky I was in the area. I don't like to judge a book by its cover or anything, but do not trust that little dude, okay? Just a word of advice, Okay, great. I'm gonna drop off that food, then I'm off to catch a scene in Gondor! I'm the fairy.
What a nice guy.
Well, well, well. It seems as if Saruman's unsustainable business practices came back to bite her after all.
Why are we looking for the hobbits here?
They were taken by Saruman's orcs, yes? Of course they would come here.
They've taken the hobbits to Isengard.
Look, speaking of Saruman's orcs, where is Saruman?
I know not, for she is hidden from me.
Okay, yeah, Legolas, get some glasses. I'm not gonna make you any less hot. New Legolas, what do you see?
Nothing stars. Saruman must have fled. Except,
they don't like my ASMR content, so I decided to pivot to...
Hey, guys! I thought you'd love the fans!
She's anyone? Huh?
Mary! Pippin, thank God you're alive!
Oh, and you as well, Legolas, you as well. Ah, oh, what a dashed fine day it is.
A fine day!
So, what happened, hobbits?
What happened here?
What happened here?
Treebeard happened. The Ents gave Saruman exactly what she deserved.
Ents? How delightful.
So Saruman is dead?
No, she escaped. She fled once she realized there was no way she could win. The whole place was oddly empty when we arrived, actually. Very few orcs were under defender. But at least Isengard Industries factory was destroyed, and that's the important bit.
Huzzah! We've avoided all sorts of terrible changes Saruman would have wrought. Air conditioning, radio, indoor plumbing, antibiotic, other infernal innovations. What a victory!
But with Saruman gone and the orcs missing,
who knows what the enemy will do next? Besides, with Isengard destroyed, their focus will certainly return to Mordor.
I dread what Saruman may be planning.
He is planning on invading Gondor.
What?
The Dark Lord Sauron is a TikTok. Weird, right?
Show me that. When you're planning to attack Minas Tirith, but Denethor's not on the
table. Denethor? Steward Gondor.
Boromir's daddy.
Oh!
Perhaps that's why this place is deserted. Saruman must have taken her armies and fled to prepare for battle.
With the combined forces of Mordor and Isengard, the men of Gondor don't stand a chance.
Then we must make haste to get... I thought you said this place was deserted.
It was!
Well, it isn't now! Brace yourselves!
In the name of good and stunny asshole, is that thing?
at one of Saruman's vile creations.
It's kind of sexy.
Pippin!
It is.
What are we here?
I don't know. It must be some sort of inside joke between the writers, cast, and directors. Sick bastard! I hope wasting our time was worth it.
What the hell are you talking about?
Okay, let's move on. Upcoming invasion? Make haste! I will ride from Minas Tirith with all speed and warn Denethor.
Yeah, because horses are so much and sentient cars. Do you even own a horse?
Yes, of course. Speaking of horses, you kids must make for Rohan, land of the horse lords. Speak with King Theoden and try to acquire his support. We will need all the help we can get. Await the lighting at the beacons.
Understood.
No, not understood. What beacons and what are horse lords?
Rohan's people are called horse lords because they breed horses as their only major export.
And what about beacons?
Oh, the beacons are a series of outposts between Edoras and Rohan and Minas Tirith and Gondor. Anytime that one country needed the aid of the other country, they would just light them and they would go over and help each other out.
Yeah, we really don't have time to explain all of this. Come with me, we must go.
Wait, what?
You're coming with me to Minas Tirith. I'd need that seeing stone of yours to show Denethor.
Oh.
I guess this is goodbye then?
I'll be sure to vlog everything.
Wait!
Yes?
We should split the leaf before we go.
That's a good idea.
No! No time for emotionally significant stash splitting. I will... It is safe for you to have later.
Sponsored by Rusty's.
So you're telling me that there's an entire country of horse girls?
Horse lords!
So there's an entire nation of horse people and you walking everywhere?
The hobbit has a point, Aragorn. This journey hasn't been easy on me, poor knees.
That's because you're wearing 50 pounds of metal armor and carrying a gigantic battle axe.
Would you put your complaining? Okay, walking builds character.
Yeah, and your sparkling personality, you attest to that, I suppose.
That matters not, okay? We must continue on. And then, wait a second. Hold. Who goes there?
You are in Rohirrim territory.
That was quick.
I am Aragorn, son of Arathorn, future awesome king of Gondor. And these are my companions. So we are here to seek aid from Lord Theoden, ruler of the Mark.
Well, today is your lucky day. I'm King Theoden.
Pardon, but what is the ruler of a large country doing out riding by himself?
I'm not alone. I have Joe with me.
Hi, I'm Joe.
Hi, Joe.
Hi, Joe.
Anyway, what was your message?
Sauron is preparing to launch an attack on Minas Tirith. Our friends are warning the Gondorians as we speak. Can we count on your aid for the coming battle?
That does sound serious. But why should Gondor ask for our help?
What?
The people of Rohan are wild and free. Just like horses. We live in a number of small, remote villages, and while I am technically king, they mostly rule themselves. I do have the power to call them to battle, but they won't be happy about it, so it must be for a good reason.
That is very civilized.
My lord, if Gondor falls, it will only be a matter of time before Rohan does as well. We must come together to defend the last stronghold of man, for if Gondor falls, all of Middle-earth may perish.
Very well. I will begin to gather my forces. When the beacon lights, we will ride for Gondor. My niece Eowyn will rule here in my stead.
Actually, sir, wouldn't it be better to have her come with you?
Is that you under there, Eowyn?
Yes.
You mean you've been Joe this whole time?
Yes.
You're still coming with me.
But I want to fight. I can ride and shoot as well as any man. You know this. Please don't leave me behind.
I'm sorry, but a battlefield is no place for a woman. Besides, ruling in my stead is still an important job, and I dare say a lot less fatal than riding to war. Now,
Let us return to Edoras and prepare.
Hey, future king of Gondor, that's pretty cool.
Yeah, I guess.
So do you like horses?
Nay.
Now, are you making a horse noise, or are you saying that you don't like them?
They're kind of lame.
Okay, geez, just trying to make conversation.
I get it. Okay, look, you're falling for me. I really can't blame you. I mean, who hasn't been a little horn for the gourd?
I really think you're getting the wrong idea here.
I'm emotionally unstable and engaged to an elven princess. Bye!
I'm not interested, douchebag!
Getting lit is my specialty. Well, I gotta recruit some hotheads in there.
Oh, for Pete's sake, Pippin, put the fun away for 1 second!
Who's Pete?
Who's you?
Oh, I'm Faramir, son of Amethor. Maybe you know my dead brother, Boromir?
Hey!
I'm at Pip420.
Oh, what's up?
Give me that. Mercanale! Damn it to Morgoth! Even mining won't work on this wood! What sorcery hath Denethor employed against us?
Water. Sorry.
Well, that's embarrassing.
I'll go get my dad. Maybe he knows what's going on. Hey. I guess daddy issues run in the family, huh? Very little lamb.
Looks like that's not the only thing that runs in the family.
Bruh, you guys look identical.
Don't go comparing me to my idiot son, halfling. Just because we look alike does not mean we are the same.
Anyway, why'd you douse the beacon in water?
To prevent people like you coming along and making things worse, okay? We got a good thing going on here, okay? And the battle is hopeless. There's no use roping Rohan into things. Besides, haven't you seen iPhone of Sauron on TikTok?
Yeah. He's got like 100,000 followers.
Right.
Granted, most of them are probably orcs and thus contractually obligated to promote him, but wait, why have you seen it?
Who isn't on TikTok?
You. According to Sauron, you do not have a TikTok.
Me! I'm not on TikTok! What is wrong with you people?
You should try it. There is a lot of good content on TikTok.
Don't try it. TikTok is a den of iniquity.
Oh, you're just saying that because people on TikTok think that you suck toes.
I do not suck toes.
Hashtag Denethor toe sucker confirmed says otherwise.
It's a smear campaign led by Sauron's media manager to make me look bad. But is the internet capable of critical thinking? No! I can't walk down the streets of my own city anymore without people pointing and laughing at me. I mean, it's a PR disaster. How am I supposed to ask Rohan for aid when my own people don't even respect me? I mean, what does Theoden think of me right now?
So, in summary, you're so ashamed of this rumor that definitely isn't true, that you purposely sabotaged your one source for reinforcements? On the eve of battle? You're about to let all of humanity be enslaved to the Dark Lord Sauron because some people on the internet think you suck toes?
You wouldn't understand.
Ever since those goddamn seeing stones started being mass produced, they've caused nothing but trouble. First they took hold of Saruman, then Big Pip over here broadcast our location to the Dark Lord with his insufferable travel blog.
But
so now
I like my phone, okay? I can take pictures, I can find places to eat, find people to date who aren't my relatives, and wait.
What?
My phone has a flashlight. A really bright flashlight?
We can use it to signal their beacons and get through to Rohan and the rest of the Fellowship.
Good idea, Pippin. I think you have more of those than people give you credit for.
Now, we just have to hope that others catch on and light their beacons to reach Rohan and the Fellowship.
Come on, everybody. Light your beacons. Light your beacons for Rohan.
So, beacon should be reaching us any minute now.
It better.
Any minute now.
You have the count of five until I throw you out of my hall. One, two, three, four. Four and a half, four and three quarters.
Yeah! Okay, there, see? Gondor calls for aid. Will you ride out with me, Leland King?
A little unorthodox, I suppose, but the times, they are changing. I'll accept this message. Riders, to arms! Hee-haw!
Yeah! I wonder what Frodo and Sam are doing right now. I sure do hope they're doing all right.
Convince King Aragorn to give a speech with me.
Oh, you let that. King Aragorn!
How about a speech?
Oh no, I'm not one for public speaking.
Speech, 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 speech!
I'm serious, I'm much more of a silently brooding type of guy.
Speech, 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 speech!
All right, well I guess if everyone... Riders! Sons of Rohan! Of Gondor! My brothers!
words!
Aragorn, yeah. I'm literally the only person here who fits that description.
Yeah, Faramir, don't literally interrupt me, okay? See over there? That's the implied offstage army. Okay, it's a little bit obvious. Okay?
My bad. You've got the stage.
All right!
Soldiers!
We're gonna get up there and kick some orc ass!
They took Boromir!
They took us!
Brickley!
But they will not take Gondor!
Nor will they take Middle-earth!
Because as previously stated!
We're gonna kick their ass!
Yeah!
What's the other way?
Thank you, Kevin! Rider of Rohan! Now everyone jump!
Wait a second, is that Eowyn in another helmet?
Hey, yes. Snuck out of Rohan, but I think we should focus on the approaching orcs.
Are my elf eyes so bad that I cannot see an entire orc army? I see maybe two, three-ish shapes right now.
Messengers. Why is it always just two of them?
Halt! Warriors of Mordor! You stand before the King of Gondor! State your purpose!
The forces of Mordor and Isengard will not besiege Gondor.
Well, why not?
There's been a coup d'etat.
A workers' revolution.
And today's our first union-mandated day off.
And we're really not interested in this whole war thing.
I can't believe it. I did it. I saved Gondor. Funny thing, I thought you were all gonna die.
Thanks for the vote of confidence, King Aragorn.
Wait. But I had this whole plan to surf down a hill on a shield while shooting at people. You can't take that away from me.
Are you serious right now?
Please consider how cool that would have looked.
But our massive army is already assembled. Can't we make use of it somehow? It would be such a waste to just disband and go home, especially after the people of Rohan went to all the trouble of getting here. Wait, everyone, we still need to strike.
Excuse me, orcs. Can you cover your ears for a second?
Thank you. We still need to distract the Eye of Sauron from the whole Frodo and Sam and the Ring thing. Can we use an army for that?
Thank you, yes! The Hobbit is right. The fight for Middle-earth is not yet over.
But the fight for Gondor is.
I say we celebrate!
Where have you been?
And the orcs are invited. They killed my brother.
Hey, Gondor-Rohan Orcs Fellowship, two hobbits mixer! We're gonna throw such a rager, Sauron won't be able to look away.
Hello, they killed my brother.
We're on it.
Think of all the FOMO that Ardaston's gonna get.
I'm seriously not okay with this. How are you two okay with this? Did they kidnap you?
Yep,
these two specific ones, actually.
Can I offer you a drink?
Milady.
Sure.
Ale! Drinking contest! Give me right now!
Gimli, my elf liver.
What the hell with your elf liver? I'm built like a bull! Drink with me!
Aragorn, you've got to try this stuff out.
Oh no, I'll just have a scotch with glass on the ice with rocks. All the cool kids, you said?
Come on, I know Elrond's anti-drug education can't be that.
Just say yes.
Well, I guess it's the first time for everything.
Have a drink with me?
Certainly. I'm Faramir, son of Denethor.
Eowyn, Tsitohay.
I never thought I'd be getting hammered side by side with an elf.
How about getting hammered side by side with a friend?
I can do that.
Something's coming! Wait, everyone! It's the Nazgul! The Nazgul are here!
Oh, shit! You guys, it's the Nazgul!
Another!
Another!
How about another hit?
Yeah!
We're definitely not getting their help!
Like, we're not a little drunk too?
Perhaps I should have told them about my elf liver.
I bet you can still do that sick shield thing if you hurry. I did it! I killed the King of Angmar!
no man could kill me. And Eowyn was like, I am no man. And then she went, and the whiskey was on. And it was,
you really had to be there.
She totally just made that name up.
I think I'm in love.
Oh dear.
Oh, that's what the whole no man can kill me thing meant.
A drink to it then.
Mary, I'm sad. We are throwing the sickest rager in the history of Middle-earth, but it doesn't feel the same without Frodo and Sam here.
You're right. I hope they're doing okay out there.
Maybe we can get someone to pick them up.
Gandalf! Can you get someone to pick up Frodo and Sam?
Yeah, I've got a whole thing planned. I'm just waiting for the mountain to explode.
Oh, cool. I hope that happens soon then.
We're so close, Mr. Frodo. Oh, come on, Mr. Frodo. Just one more step, and it'll be the farthest from home I've ever been.
That is literally the thousandth time you've said that.
Well, it's true.
I don't care how true it is. I know we're climbing into a literal volcano and probably going to die in the next few minutes. But I want you to know that at least half of my misery is all your fault.
Oh, come on, Mr. Frodo. You don't mean that.
Maybe I don't. I need to think about something other than the ring. It's all I can think about. Every moment, how much I just want to put it in my mouth.
You can't get up now! No, when we're so close! Just one more step, Mr. Frodo. One more step and...
Yes. Farthest from home and all that.
No, I mean, we're here. Journey's end.
Those are the fires of Mount Doom, right?
I think Gandalf called it the crack of doom.
All I've got to do is just throw it in, right?
Yep, just yeet that ring right into the volcano. Just gotta yeet that ring into the volcano.
No, Sam.
Yeet into the volcano.
It's mine. It's all mine. Mine to suck. I won't let the cracks have it.
No, Mr. Frodo. Don't stick it in your mouth. Mr. Frodo, where are you? Come back.
Who has our nurses' backs? Andrew smells nasty, fucking hobbit slime. Andrew smells the precious too. Ours again! The precious is ours!
You bitch! Frodo is mine! My precious!
Sam? I put my finger in the cracks of doom. That's how I saved the world. I think I can die happy now, knowing that.
Oh no, Mr. Frodo, we can still pull out. We have to. You have to pull out, Mr. Frodo.
I can see the Shire, Bag End. I've won Bagshot Row, Hobbiton, the Shire. It's still mine. I didn't leave my curling iron on after all.
Hey there, looks like you guys could use a towel.
No.
Yes, 1,000 times yes. We hobbits love taking handouts from eagles.
Alrighty, off we go then. I'll follow, fella. Come on. Is he alive? Okay, cool. Eagleus ex machinus, away! Whoa!
Woo!
it, my boy. The ring is destroyed.
What is it, Mr. Frodo? Ghost!
Either she's a ghost?
We're all dead!
No, no, Frodo, none of us are dead. I'm alive. I was born again after my fight with the Balrog. Well, not in like a religious way, I was literally reborn. It was terribly convenient. I got a new outfit!
That's the main thing!
Oh. Well, in that case, it's lovely to see you again.
And you as well.
Oh, my poor head.
Frodo! Sam! You're awake! Hey guys, Frodo and Sam are awake!
Frodo and Sam are awake?
Frodo and Sam are awake!
Frodo and Sam are awake!
I thought I'd never see you guys again!
No, we knew you'd do it. You two are the most based and red-pilled hobbits that ever lived.
You guys have missed a great party, but we saved some of the good egg cushions to make up for it.
About that.
Yeah.
So in a moment of weakness, I may have smoked the rest of the good kush.
The good kush we're saving for Frodo and Sam?
Frodo and Sam's good kush.
Okay. We don't need weed. We have friendship, and that is worth all the weed in the world.
Aw, shucks, guys. Come give me another hug.
Frodo, Sam, we are truly proud of what you've done today.
There was never a doubt in my mind you could do it.
Must have been easy for the second and third hottest people I know.
Thank you. All. Thank you all so much. I'm Eowyn. It's a pleasure to meet you. What? I've never met them before. And Faramir only met them, like, once.
Hey, guys. Actually, Eowyn, I was thinking maybe we could give them a more private reunion. There's something I wanted to talk to you about.
What did you want to talk about?
Well, it's just... I thought it was pretty freaking badass the way you slayed the Witch King. I was wondering if you wanted to go back to our cities and rule them and have a cool alliance. Aragorn said I could keep being steward if I call him daddy.
Sounds tight. You seem pretty badass yourself, but in a sensitive, responsible way.
Being responsible has never felt so good.
Hey, this might be coming out of left field, but do you by any chance like horses?
Hi. I love horses. Secretariat, Trojan, Rainbow Dash, you name it.
Whoa. Let's get married.
Done.
So, it's all done then. The one ring is destroyed. What now?
About that. Frodo, you got this notice in the mail. Don't ask how we found you. It appears there was a house fire at Bag End. My house and all of my belongings have been obliterated.
That's terrible. Looks like you did leave your curling iron on after all.
I'm really sorry, Frodo. You know, I'm not as upset about it as you might think.
Is it because everything you care about in the whole wide world is with you right now?
That's part of it. But also, before he left, Bilbo got some really good insurance on the house. So. Well, I'm glad you're taking things with a positive attitude. That might change if I think about it for too long. What are you guys doing now that the war is over?
Well, I'm King of Gondor now, so that's happening. But apparently there's some peasant revolt, something about the price of bread being excruciatingly high and the massive exploitation of the working class. I think the orcs were handing out pamphlets.
That doesn't sound fun. Don't you have anything nice to look forward to?
You would think so, but no, actually. You see, the writers had to cut out all of my character development for the sake of time, so I never really got any personality outside of a grumpy, long-lost king. So, you know, it's gonna take a lot of soul-searching. So I'll just get that done. Yeah. Bye.
Legolas and I are going to Six Flags.
I have a season pass.
Wait, don't you think you're a little for Six Flags?
No, oh, don't you worry about that, lad.
I don't think that will be a problem.
Probably be heading home then too.
Too true. Mary and I have vlogs to edit, house is all sorted.
Can't wait to see the Shire again.
This is the closest to home I've been in a long time.
That's our show! Yeah.